الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد
الله أكبر 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 الحمد لله الذي بنعمته تتم الصالحات الحمد لله الذي خلق الأرض والسماوات له الحمد ما تتابعت بالقلب النبضات وله الحمد ما تعاقبت الخطوات وله الحمد عدد حبات الرمال في الفلوات وعدد ذرات الهواء في الأرض والسماوات وعدد الحركات والسكنات وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ولا مثيل له ولا نظير له في علو شأنه وعظيم سلطانه وأشهد أن سيدنا وسندنا ومولانا محمدا عبده وحبيبه ورسوله أرسله الله تعالى رحمة للعالمين صلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وأزواجه وذريته وخلفائه الراشدين المهديين من بعده وزرائه الكاملين العاملين في عهده خصوصا منهم على الأئمة خلفاء رسول الله على التحقيق أمراء المؤمنين حضرات أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي ذوي القدر الجلي وعلى بقية الصحابة والتابعين رضوان الله تعالى عليهم أجمعين أيها المؤمنون الحاضرون اتقوا الله وأطيعوه إن الله مع الذين اتقوا والذين هم محسنون قال الله تعالى في كتابه المنزل على لسان نبيه المرسل لن ينال الله لحومها ولا دماؤها ولكن يناله التقوى منكم كذلك سخرها لكم لتكبروا الله على ما هداكم وبشر المحسنين الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر على أنعمه على كرمه على عطائه سبحانه وتعالى الحمد لله على نعمة الإسلام والإيمان O believers, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته Another Eid, another year We are all witnesses to the fact that the time today has shrunk I don't know about you, but my days go like hours. It's 3 o'clock, and then I look, it's 8 o'clock. What happened? I didn't do anything. I maybe sat down and sipped some coffee, and it's already 5 hours past. Like this. And this is one of the prophetic prophecies of the end of times. Prophet ﷺ said that يَتَقَارَبُ الزَّمَانِ That the time at the end of times will shrink. صلى الله عليه وسلم He said السنة كالشهر يعني أو كما قال النبي The year is like the month is like the week is like the day and the day is like the hour and in سيدنا أحمد's مسند there's and the hour is like puncturing something in a paper like you take something you go like this that's how much the hour is we are living it But we have much to be grateful for. As much as what's going around us saddens our heart and the difficulties that our fellow Muslims are experiencing, still Ummatul Islam, in all its colors, in all its variations, Ummatul Marhum, it's mercied Ummah. Even our afflictions are mercy. Even our difficulties are mercy. Even when we go through hardship, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for believers is either raising them, taking away their sins. Subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ummatul Islam, Ummatun Aziza. What we wanted to speak about here is what is the object of our faith? Why are we religious? Why are we Muslims? Why do we come to pray? Why do we fast? Why do people go to Hajj? It's very difficult. not only difficult on your physical being, it's difficult on the pocket. Many people opting not to go because it's too expensive these days. So you have to go against so many obstacles to get there, against your inclination not to spend money, against your inclination not to tire yourself, against maybe your fears of being amongst big crowds. Many obstacles you have to go there. The object of ibadah is tazkiyatun nafs, is the purification. In Holy Quran, Allah says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made it fard for fasting so that you attain taqwa. What is taqwa? God consciousness. To be aware that you are a servant. To know that you have a Lord that is watching you at all times. To know that He owns you. To be aware in that state. Awliya, those who attain wilaya, they're always aware of this. That's what makes him awliya. One person didn't believe in awliya Allah, and he heard there's a wali. So he went to him, he wants to make fun of him in front of people. So he said, I have a question, Shaykh. He says, what it is? He said, you tell me something profound that you do every day. He said, every day I wake up in the morning and I think this is going to be my last day. I might die any minute. And I go in the evening to bed and I think this is maybe my last night. He says, what is this, Sheikh? Everyone knows that anyone can die at any time. What is this profound wisdom you are giving me? He said, yes, but who thinks about it every day? That's the question. Who thinks about their mortality every day? Who thinks that this moment now in time we have may be our last moment? This Eid may be our last Eid. Eid al-Adha. Who's aware? Who's conscious? Another ibadah, prayer, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ الصَّلَاةَ تَنْهَى عَنِ الْفَحْشَاءِ وَالْمُنْكَرِ. That your prayer, the object of your prayer, to remember Allah, but it should make you well-mannered. It should make you stay away from bad things, from corrupt things. Okay? This is the object of ibadah. It's not an exercise of our physical being and all the hardship. That's why we are ordered to be servants. If a servant is ill-mannered, would you keep him around? You hire somebody. Now, in these countries, you can't use this even. I don't know if it's politically correct to say servants. No. But you go to third world countries, people have servants. They come. If you have a servant at home that has ill manners, that has bad character, would you keep him around? Even though he's very good at what he does. He may be the task you hired him for, he may be perfect at it. But if, for example, he has no shyness, or he transgresses against the limits with your family, or whatever it is, you will not keep him around. You will fire him. So the object is not how good you are at worshiping. It's how good-mannered you are. It's how well-mannered you are. It's adab. First and foremost, your ibadah, your hajj, everything must make you well-mannered. Only good-mannered ones are accepted in that divine presence. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala indicated in many ahadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned that لَا يَدْخُلُ الْجَنَّةَ مَنْ كَانَ فِي قَلْبِهِ مِثْقَالُ ذَرَّةٍ مِنْ كِبَرٍ. If you have kibar, arrogance, pray as much as you like. You're not going to smell heaven. You're not going to enter. It's not allowed. You have something, and they scan you. The machine beeps. Yes, kibar, throw them out. Finish. So well-mannered, good manners are important, are actually the object of worship. إنما حديث النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إنما بعثت لأتمم مكارم الأخلاق. Verily, my mission of being sent by Allah is for exclusively for teaching you good manners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And how you attain good manners with Allah. Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he is Sayyidul Khalq. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, أَدَّبَنِي رَبِّي فَأَحْسَنَ تَأْدِيبِي. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is the one that taught Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم his good manners. Allah. But we're not in that league to be taught manners by Allah. Even by prophets. Alhamdulillah, Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, my message, after my message, I'm the seal of prophets. But he said that I have inheritors. علماء أمتي كأنبياء بني إسرائيل. So, the way for good manners is to be with people who are well-mannered. Well-mannered with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Well-mannered with His creation. And these are awliyaullah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us to be with them. وقال تعالى هو الذي بعث في الأميين رسولا منهم يتلو عليهم آياته ويزكيهم ويعلمهم الكتاب والحكمة وإن كانوا من قبل لفي ضلال مبين. That Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was sent according to this verse to teach us to recite his Allah's verses on us and purify us. ويزكيهم تزكية, good manners. What is tazkiyah? Teaching us good manners, instilling us in us good manners. After tazkiyah, وَيُعَلِّمَهُمْ, then he teaches them. Tazkiyah first, then knowledge. Because knowledge without good manners, if it would have benefited anybody, it would have benefited Satan. عَلَيْهِ مَا يَسْتَحِقُ. He was alim in all the books. He was knowledgeable. He was a big worshipper. Before he fell from grace, before he was cursed. So first tazkiyah, first adab, manners. So if we have nothing else to understand from today, is that Ya Rabbi, I'm making intention to be a good servant, a well-mannered servant, according to the prophetic manners that you taught to Sayyidina Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. Grant me to be accepted so that when one day we reach in Allah's presence, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, come, my servant. إِلَّا مَنْ أَتَى اللَّهِ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ. Except those who come to Allah with a pure heart. No ill manners, no arrogance, no jealousy, no enmity, no thinking ill of people. Pure hearts. May Allah grant us those hearts. قولوا قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم. الحمد لله حمد الكاملين. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر. الحمد لله حمد الكاملين والصلاة والسلام على سيد الأنبياء والمرسلين إمام المتقين قائد الغر المحجلين مولانا ومولى الثقلين سيدنا أبي القاسم محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. The best way to attain good manners is through loving those with good manners. This center here is called Know Your Prophet Center. Because Sayyidina Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, he represents the perfection of human attainment of good manners. صلوات ربي وسلامه عليه. There is no one who is more perfect than Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم in his manners, in his creation. صلوات ربي وسلامه عليه. That's why there is emphasis in Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah, in Sufi Turuq, on attachment to the Prophet, love of the Prophet, respect of the Prophet, honoring the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. This is essential because if you love someone, it molds you into becoming like them. We don't have to go far, or our children who follow football stars and movie stars and influencers. Yeah, they come one day, they're fine. Next day, they want to shave their head in a certain way, put on clothes in a certain way. What happened? Oh, I like this guy. I love this guy. I think really highly of this guy. That's why I'm emulating him. So this is the easiest way to attain good manners, is to love Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, is to love pious people. And in this day, one of the most important practices of Eid is to show happiness and to instill happiness and to make everybody around you happy. We said this before. قُلْ بِفَضْلِ وَاسْتَعِبْلَ اللَّهِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى says in Holy Quran, قُلْ بِفَضْلِ اللَّهِ وَبِرَحْمَتِهِ فَبِذَلِكَ فَلْيَفْرَحُوا. Let them rejoice in Allah's mercy. Let them rejoice in Allah's favors, in Allah's ni'am on them. Let them show happiness. Part of showing, part of gratitude is to be happy. And we'll end with this one. There's a Sufi story I read maybe 20 years ago, a book by, he had a series, Allah bless him. He talked about King Mahmud and his servant. King Mahmud had a servant that he loved very much, well-mannered servant. And he was very happy. He kept him close to him. And one day, they brought King Mahmud a basket of freshly picked fruit, vegetables. And in it, there was a cucumber. And as you, I don't know if you people grow cucumbers, you would every now and then get one that is bitter. So, Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad. So he, King Mahmud took this cucumber, split it in two, and he gave half to his servant, and he started to eat the other half. When he bit into it, it was so bitter. That his inclination, he was about to spit it out, and he looked at his servant, and his servant was eating it like it was honey. Like he gave him chocolate or whatever. He was eating it so sweet. And he's looking astonishing at his servant. He said, you have a different cucumber. It's the same cucumber I gave you. This is so bitter, and that one, you're eating it like it's sweet. He said, my king, he said, anything from your hand is sweet to me. This is an analogy. It's a story, but it's supposed to teach us something. This is how we have to be with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The one who gives us everything, that even if we get one day a bitter cucumber, be happy, alhamdulillah. It's from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, your Lord. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make you happy and make those around you happy. Be a person, when you're around, your family is happy to see you. Your neighbors are happy to see you when they see you. Your community is happy to see you. Don't be from these people, the difficult people, where when they see you, they turn and go the other way. Or they say, I have to see this person. Don't be like that. A Muslim is hayyin layyin. People of heaven are sweet, easygoing, understanding, flexible. These are the akhlaq, these are the manners. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us happy Eid. Grant us many Eids on Iman and Islam and Ihsan, inshaAllah. Wa min Allahi tawfiq, kullu amin wa antum bi khair. Allahumma ghafir lil mu'minina wal mu'minat, wal muslimina wal muslimat. الأحياء منهم والأموات اللهم اجعل لنا من لدنك وليا واجعل لنا من لدنك سلطانا نصيرا اكتب الصحة والسلامة علينا وعلى الحجاج والزوار والمسافرين في برك وبحرك وجوك من أمة محمد اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وأذل الشرك والكافرين اللهم انصر أهل غزة وفلسطين اللهم انصر المسلمين اللهم اظهر لنا صاحب الزمان سيدنا محمد المهدي عليه السلام اللهم اجعلنا من أتباعه ومن جنوده يا رب العالمين وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون وذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون كل عام وأنتم بخير Now, I know we're post-corona, but hadith in Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, when Muslim shakes the hand of Muslims, their sins fall off. So in the, our Sheikh from Turkey taught us, after big events, we go around and we greet each other. And this is Eid.
Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad.